YouTube family, welcome back to another video. I hope you're all doing well. I hope you're all doing good, and if you're new here, hello, my name's Kimberly and I hope you subscribe. Turn your bell notifications on to get notified every single time that I upload, and give this video a massive thumbs up to be a part of my weight loss journey channel. As you guys can tell from the title of today's video, I'm going to be giving you 4 quick fire tips on how to lose weight and keep it off. Now, these are ones that don't get said enough and I thought would be really good for your midweek motivation, and things that really helped me on my now 40 pound weight loss, which is crazy and insane because you guys have been part of this entire journey, and I'm just so happy I get to share these tips with you every single day. Now, don't forget to come over and follow my inspirational fitness page on Instagram, where you get a more behind the scenes of my day-to-day life, as well as my personal Instagram page as well. So, jumping straight into it, tip number one, and dieting too much. Now, dieting too much can actually cause you to not lose any weight. This is coming from someone who was dieting 3 years straight and yo-yo dieting and never ever being able to lose weight. I'd lose 5 pounds, gain 10 pounds, lose 20 pounds, gain 30 pounds back, and it was this constant cycle of not being able to lose weight. As well as that, I was trying a million other crash diets at the same time, so these crazy tea diets, fit diets, all these types of things. And actually what it does to the body is dieting constantly slows down your metabolism. That comes from either not eating enough calories or doing the wrong methods, putting your body under so much strain it can ruin the metabolism that you have, that for us can be so frustrating at times where we think, why is it not working faster? But actually it will do the counter opposite thing, and it will slow down tremendously by continuously dieting. Even in my healthy eating routine now, which, you know, I don't like to call it dieting, I just like to call it healthy lifestyle, but this new, let's say, dieting for the sake of this explanation, I have days where it's really important to add those cheat days. And when you guys ask me over a DM or in the comment section how many cheat days I have, how important cheat days are, I always say how important it really is, because it shakes up the body, it resets it, and allows the metabolism to really get its rebalance back, because it's not used to eating less calories. So it's really important that you always keep a balance of both. And our constantly dieting is really going to put your metabolism into a huge shock, and it's not good for the system at all, as well as the mind, because this constant level of dieting where you're 100% in or 100% out is the reason why we end up having this catalyst of unsuccessful weight loss journeys. So I really think it's important for yourself to have specific days where you understand, like, okay, I really need to incorporate, you know, a more relaxed eating day, or I'm having a healthy lifestyle, not a diet, or I'm 100% committed to not going on these crazy get fit quick diets, because it really does ruin the whole process for you, especially when it comes to the idea of keeping the weight off, which is going to be more important than anything, because there's nothing worse than reaching your fitness goal for a week or two and that's it, because you've already started to rebound back to your old methods and old ways. The faster you lose it, the quicker you gain it back. So it's really important to know that when you're doing these things and doing these heavy diets, that maintenance level, that keeping it off, won't last as long. So having that in mind is so important. Tip number two. Now, another unsuccessful thing to a weight loss journey is always believing that every single person you see is naturally thin. Now, I, in secondary school, was always the bigger friend, and always, every event that I went to, every place that I went, I always felt like I was larger than every single other person. Now, one of the things I will say about this is when you see your slimmer friends eating loads of food, or you see your favorite fitness influencer digging into like these burgers and these pizzas and these takeaways and these sweets, or even it's at work and you see people constantly pulling out sweets and thinking, how are you eating that but staying slim? What you don't realize behind closed doors is you're only seeing that snippet. Even if that person, and I'll honestly tell you this, even if that person was every single day at lunchtime was bringing in a very unhealthy meal for lunch, that is only a fraction of the entire day, and you're not seeing them every single weekend or every single waking day. So a person could be eating that one meal in front of you or posting a picture of that one meal, but what they eat for the other 365 days or other 24 hours of the day actually is the major catalyst to the results that they end up seeing in their day-to-day physique and figure, or this naturally skinny thing that we have in our minds. And I would honestly say that on the majority, I know a lot of people have very fast metabolisms, but do not beat your metabolism up, because actually you're only seeing a fraction of what they're eating, and they could be eating healthy or perhaps skipping meals for the rest of the, you know, for the rest of the day to cater in that fullness that they feel, because maybe they get fuller faster. And it really is that difference that you're not seeing what the person is eating for the rest. Don't be too hard on yourself on a weight loss journey thinking, oh, they can eat whatever they want, they stay slim. Actually, you know, you don't know what they're doing or what they're exercising or how many meals they don't eat during the week that you might eat. So again, it's that catalyst of that balance, and this is why I end up going and reverting back to why cheat meals are so important in a weight loss journey, is because that one meal, like you're seeing the other people eat that one meal, does doesn't do anything compared to the other 23 hours of the day, how you spend your time or what you spend your time doing in that day or what you're eating on the other 23 hours. And that's what ends up solidifying the results you end up seeing, which is why I say your cheat meal habit. Tip number three, and now this one's so important for my young viewers, people who have had long successful journeys of weight loss or people who are just starting, is that I'm a strong believer that you can't buy your fitness. Unless it's a gym membership or a workout plan or whatever it is you choose to buy, I am a huge believer that these diet pills, these things that, you know, the Kardashians used to sell, these flat tummy teas and these, you know, weight loss medicines that you ingest and all that type of stuff is not good for your longevity, especially when we really refer back to the title of this video, which is keeping it off and maintaining it, is that your body, you A, haven't trained yourself to be able to cope in methods of temptation because you're relying on these methods and these things that you're buying, these supplements that you're buying. Second, you're not teaching yourself and training your body to cope with a new reduction of the calories that you're taking, the new nutrition that you're taking. You're still, again, relying on these methods. And also, these are very, if they even work, which not many reviews point to the fact that they work, are very fast, quick methods, which again, referring back to these fast dieting fads or dieting trends, weight loss is calories in versus calories out. And when you're buying these things, they're not supporting that idea at all. In fact, what are they doing? You just really need to focus on your nutrition, exercise, nutrition. That is that. If you're spending all these money, all you're doing is feeding these massive corporations that label all these things healthy and good for you when they're not actually at all. So don't buy your weight loss. Don't buy these things, these supplements, all these types of that stuff, unless it's organic and healthy, because otherwise you're going to be really disappointed because you're going to be taking all these things. And I am with you. I used to 100% believe these things would work. I would think, let me invest, you know, so much money on it, every last penny I had, because the results I'm going to see hold me back, because the results that I'm going to see are going to be incredible. And no, it doesn't work like that. And I don't know many people who actually works like that, because that is not the science behind weight loss. Say this is the science behind weight loss, you're doing something over there that has nothing to do with this. So really, really focus on your food and nutrition, and don't feed these corporations and give them more money, because it doesn't work. I can promise you that one. Tip number four is the common misconception that you need to cut out fats, carbs, and sugars, all these other things. Now, number one thing I'll tell you about this, especially when we go back to the thing about keeping it off, the more you cut out the things that you've always had, the more you'll want it back. This is why I say pasta, bread, rice, the more you cut it out and the more you say, I'm not gonna have this, I'm gonna go, you know, all out, cutting it, cutting it, cutting it, the more you're gonna want it back. And that's why I think it's important to have a day in the week where you eat pasta, a day in the week where you have rice for lunch, or even have sushi, has a bit of rice in it. Sushi is fantastic. I'm sure you've seen a million other influencers on Instagram eating sushi like there's no tomorrow. And it's because it is still good for you to a certain extent, especially when you're trying to incorporate that balance. It's really important. Now, you guys know how obsessed I am with bread. I have at least 2 slices of bread every single day without fail. And I want you to realize the difference between that, because when I started my weight loss journey in the past, I used to think, let me cut out all these things and live off vegetables and fruit. And in fact, you know, because those fruits filled with sugar, people say good sugars, it's still sugar. It's going to spike your insulin. And actually, bread would have been more regulating for the system and your cravings than a bowl of fruit would ever be. So again, don't cut out these things. It's impossible to have a good method and system without carbohydrates. Carbohydrates are going to be fantastic for your weight loss journey. It's going to be fantastic for your mind, and to not feel left out as well. So if your family eat pasta, rice, knowing that you can still have it, just reduce the portions a little bit and you'll be good to go. Like, guys, I hope you have found these tips useful. These are things that I used, as well as check out my what I eat in a day videos. If you want to see a weight loss workout routine video, do give this video a massive thumbs up so I know that you want to see that. Check out my workout plans, link in the description. Also, come over and follow me on my inspirational fitness page on Instagram, as well as my personal Instagram page as well. And if you want to see a what I eat in a day, an updated one, do give this video a massive thumbs up as well. Now, I love you guys so much, and I'll see you guys very, very soon. Bye, guys.